إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، إن من مقاصد هذا الدين الشريف طهارة الأنفس. Really, from the objectives of this honorable religion is to purify ourselves. جاء في الصحيح مسلم وصح في غيره من حديث أبي مالك الأشعري أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الطهور شطر الإيمان. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, purification is half of Iman. أي اجتناب النواهي نصف الدين وهو الطهارة. Hey, avoiding prohibitions in this religion is purification in half of your religion. نعم يا عباد الله. وربنا سبحانه وتعالى بين في كتابه الكريم أن جميع أوامره ونواهيه لطهارة الأنفس. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he explains in his book that all of his commandments and all of his prohibitions is for the purification of your mind and your heart. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ما يريد الله ليجعل عليكم من حرج. Allah doesn't want to place any difficulty on you. ولكن يريد ليطهركم وليتم نعمته عليكم. But he wants to purify you all and complete his favor upon you. كما يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى مبينا المقاصد الشرعية. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he's explaining the objectives of this legislation of Islam. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجَسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Only Allah only wants to remove from you impurities, O family of the Prophet, and to purify you a good purification. نعم يا عباد الله هكذا ديننا. والله سبحانه وتعالى يحث العباد على طهارة الباطن للقلوب والطهارة الظاهرة للأبدان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he encourages the believers to purify themselves internally as far as their minds and their hearts, and to purify also outwardly as far as their bodies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah loves those who repent. They relieve themselves and they repent to Allah from their disobedience to Him. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. He loves those that keep themselves pure. نعم يا عباد الله. وكما يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها المدثر. Oh, you who's gathered up in your clothing, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قم فأنذر, get up and warn about the promise of, about the punishment of Allah. وربك فكبر, and your Lord, glorify Him and magnify Him. وثيابك فطهير, in your clothing, purify your clothing. والرجزة فاهجر, in the filth of worshiping other than Allah, abandon that and leave that. نعم يا عباد الله. ويقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يحذرنا من العنجاس وأرجاس في المعاملات وفي العبادات وفي الأقوال وفي المعتقد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He warns us from filth in our actions, in our beliefs, and in our speech. فَجِتَنِبُوا الرِّجِسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَجِتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. Avoid the filth of worshiping other than Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it rijis, and that is filth, and that is dirty. Avoid the filth of worshiping other than Allah, and avoid the filth of false statements. كما جاء في البخاري من حديث عبد الله ابن عمرو بن عاص رضي الله عنه قال لم يكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فاحشا ولا متفحشا أي ما تكلم بكلام قبيح ولا تكلف ولا تعمد ذلك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he didn't use profanity and speak vile language, nor did he go out his way and do that on purpose, where يتكلفه, and go out of his way to be nasty and to be repulsive. نعم يا عباد الله يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى لمسجد أسس على التقوى من أول يوم أحق أن تقوم فيه. The masjid that was established upon taqwa and piety from the first day, this is the more right that you have to stand it in and pray in it. فيه رجال يحبون أن يتطهروا. In that masjid, there are men, they love to purify themselves. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُطَّهِرِينَ. And Allah loves those that keep themselves pure. Concerning this ayah, أخرج ابن ماجه رحمه الله تعالى من حديث جابر بن عبد الله وأنس بن مالك رضي الله عنهما. لما نزلت هذه الآية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا معشر الأنصار. When this ayah came down, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called out to the Ansar. فقال إن الله يثني عليكم في الطهور فما طهوركم. Really, Allah has praised you all, Ansar, because of your purification. Your purification. So how do you purify yourselves? قالوا نتوضع للصلاة. They say we make wudu and ablution for the salah. وَنَغْتَسِلُ مِنَ الْجَنَابَةِ. And we take a bath after having relations. وَنَسْتَنْجِي بِالْمَاءِ. And we clean ourselves with water after relieving ourselves. وَكَانِ الْآخُرُونَ يَسْتَجْمِرُونَ. And everybody else other than the Sahabas, they were cleaning themselves with rocks. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَهُوَ ذَاكَ فَعَلَيْكُمُوهُ أَيْ فَأَلْزِمُوهُ. He said, that's the reason why Allah praised you all. Because you clean yourself with water. Hold fast to that. نعم يا عباد الله. وجاء في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الفطرة خمس. There are five things that's from the natural disposition of humanity, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them on this natural inclination of being upright and being clean. فذكرهن صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال الختان circumcision. والاستحداد shaving off your pubic hairs from your aura, from your private area. وقصر الشارب shaving your mustache. وتقليم الأظفار and cutting your fingernails and your toenails. ونتف الإبط and cutting the ears from your underarms, the hair from your underarms. نعم يا عباد الله فإن في الختان لحكمة عظيمة فإن في هذا البشر وهذا الجلد تجتمع فيه أنجاس من البول والأقدار من المني. نعم يا عباد الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded with moving this skin that's at the tip of the private part of the man, because it gathers in it the filth of urine and the impurity of urine and the filth of sperm. Na'am ya ibadullah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded with istihdad and shaving the hairs off of your aura, al-aura, yuhtad kullaha al-qubul wa-dubur. Na'am ya ibadullah. All of the hairs from your private part, that which is in the front and that which is in the back, لِأَنَّهُ يَجْتَمِعْ فِيهِ أَنْجَاسْ وَأَرْجَاسْ. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. All of the hair from your private part, from the front and from the back, is to be removed because nasty waste and filthy impurities gather on that and it stays in your body. When that's what qasr the shadab and your mustache, stajma' fihi an-nukhama, and the mucus from your nose, it sits in your mustache, wa illam tadri, and even if you don't know it, wa taqlim al-afar, and cutting off your nails, tajtama' fihi anjas wa arjas, tatahhar minhu, ya Abdullah, and even under your fingernails, it gathers in it all kinds of filth and waste. One that's full ibit and cutting the hairs under your underarms. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those that are pure. Alhamdulillah. Hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fi. Kama yuhibbu rabbuna wa yirada. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasul sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Ikhwati fillah, ka'anna hunaka fitra li taharat al abdan fa hunaka fitra li taharat al anfus wal qulub. Just as there's a fitra, a natural disposition to keep your bodies clean, and there's also a natural disposition that Allah commanded to keep your minds clean and to keep your heart clean from filth, where the filth that's on your mind is far greater and more dangerous than the filth that comes to your body. فَتَنَبَّهْ, be careful, wake up, be aware. يَقُلُ رَبُّنَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَأَقِمْ وَجَهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطَرَ النَّاسَ عَلَيْهَا. Now turn your face sincerely to worshiping Allah alone. Don't worship other than Allah. Fitrat Allah. This is the natural disposition alati fatar Allah an-nas alayh, that Allah created the human mind upon. Na'am ya ibadallah. Wa yubayyinu rabbuna subhanahu wa ta'ala wa yaqul ya ayyuhalladhina amanu innamal mushrikuna najas. Ay, ma'nawiyan la hissiyan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the mushrikun, O you who believe, rather the mushrikun, the disbelievers, they're najis, they're impure. Na'am, li'anna ash-shirki billah najasa, because worship other than Allah is impure. Na'am ya ibadallah. Wa yuhuthu rabbuna subhanahu wa ta'ala ala taharati al-qulubi min al-anjasi wal-arjas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He encourages us to purify our minds from filth. Na'am ya ibadallah. Fa yaqulu rabbuna jalla wa ala qad aflaha man zakkaha azzakka nafsahu bitta'ah wa qad khaba man dassaha ay dassaha bil ma'asi. Nasallallahu al-afiyah. Yaqulu rabbuna subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is successful, the one who purifies his soul, He purifies his mind with obedience to Allah, and he's destroyed. He's a loser. The one that buries his soul, buries it with disobedience, buries it with the filth of sins. Na'am ya ibadallah. Wa inna min maqasid al-hijab taharatul qulub. And very the objective of the hijab in Islam, that there's a hajiz, there's a barrier between the men and the women. The purpose of it, وَالْدِحَارَتْ قُلُوبِكُمْ, is for the cleanliness of your hearts. فَالْتَزِمُوهَا, hold fast to the hijab. يَقُلُ رَبُّنَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُنَّ مَتَاعًا, if you ask them, the woman, for anything, فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَاب, ask them from behind the hijab, from behind the barrier. ذَلِكُمْ أَطْهَرْ لِقُلُوبِكُمْ وَقُلُوبِهِنَّ, that's more purer, that's more cleaner for your hearts and for their hearts. اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ فِي الْحِجَابِ لَا تَسَاحَلُوهَا هُوَ لِقُلُوبِكُمْ وَلِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَلِقُلُوبِ أَهْلِكُمْ. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Don't think small of the hijab. It's for the purification of your heart, and the purification of your soul, and the purification of your family and your wives. Na'am ya ibadallah. Wa min al-najasa alladhi tuwassiq al-adhan al-aghani wa musiqa, from the filth and repulsiveness that clogs and pollutes the mind of man is music and singing. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ومن الناس من يشتري لهو الحديث. And from amongst mankind are those who choose and they prefer. They prefer على صحة عقولهم يختار على العقل السليم الأغاني والموسيقى. They choose for themselves over their minds that they have, over their clear-headedness. They choose music and singing لِيُضِلَّ النَّاسَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ الْعِلْمِ, to take the people away from the path of Allah, and they don't even recognize it. They don't even realize that they're going astray. وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوًا أَن يَتَّخِذُ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ فِي الْحَرَامِ وَفِي الْحَلَالِ هُزُوًا وَاسْتِهْزَاءً. And they take what Allah has made halal and haram, and they sing about that which Allah had made haram, and they glorify it out of mockery for him, out of mockery of it. Na'am ya ibadullah. Ula'ika lahum adhabun muheen. Li'anahum ahanu anfusahum wa uqulahum. For them is a humiliating punishment, because they humiliated their intelligence. They sold their intelligence for music, and when it comes back, it's not the same. ومن الأنجاس الذي تخرب عقول الناس الخموري. نعم يا عباد الله والميسر. From the filth that corrupts the mind of man is intoxicants, from liquor and alcohol and marijuana and all kinds of drugs and gambling. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون. Oh, you who believe, verily intoxicants and gambling and making divine stones and arrows, this is from the filth of the work of shaitan. فاجتنبوه, stay away from it so that you may be successful. إنما يريد الشيطان أن يوقع بينكم العداوة والبغضاء في الخمر والميسر. Shaitan only wants to put enmity and hatred amongst yourselves with drinking intoxicants and by gambling. اجتنبوها ما أسهل تناولها في هذا الزمان. How easy it is to come across intoxicants and drugs in this time. How easy it is to gamble. احذر يا عبد الله, be careful and not fall into that. ومن الأنجاس ومن الأوساخ, and من filth that you have to protect your mind from is pornography, also fornication and homosexuality. هذا أنجاس ونجاس للعقول. That is filth, pornography and fornication and homosexuality. It's wasakha. It is filthy. It is dirty. يخرب عقلك يا عبد الله. It's going to harm you. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ولوطا إذ قال لقومه. ولوط, he said to his people, أتأتون الفاحشة وأنتم تبصرون. Are you entering upon this major nasty sin and you all are aware of its filth? أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَأْتُونَ الرِّجَالَ شَهْوَةً مِنْ دُونِ النِّسَاءِ. Are you coming to men with desires as opposed to women? بَلْ أَنْتُمْ قَوْمٌ تَجْهَلُونَ. You are people in jahiliyyah. These are affairs of ignorance and jahal. فَمَا كَانَ جَوَابَ قَوْمِي. What was the response of his people? إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا. Except that they said, أَخْرِجُوا عَلَى لُوطٍ مِنْ قَرْيَتِكُمْ. Kick out Lut and his family from our village. إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ يَتَطَهَرُونَ. قَالُوا ذَلِكَ إِسْتِهْزَاءٌ. اعترافٌ على وساقتهم, اعترافٌ على أنفسهم أنهم وسخين. نعم يا عباد الله. They said, kick these people out of your village. There are people, Lut and his people, there are people, they try to keep themselves clean and pure. And this is admitting that they're dirty and that they're nasty. They admitted themselves that they're repulsive. فَحْذَرُوا يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. Hold fast to your mind. Some people, they lose their liver and they live well. They might lose a kidney and they live happily. And they might lose a foot or their eyesight and they live well. But if you lose your mind, you're a loser. If your mind goes, you're a loser. Ya Abdullah, hafidhu ala nafsik. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى أولئك الذين لم يرد الله أن يطهر قلوبهم لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم. They are the ones Allah did not want to purify their hearts. Allah didn't want to purify their souls. They have a humiliating punishment in this world. And in the hereafter, they have a painful punishment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our minds and our bodies. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us far from the unjust and that which is impure. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَٰلِكَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمْ.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.